death in our breaking news story this afternoon in Tshwane, indeed, due to the flooding. At the same time, Gauteng MEC for Human Settlements and Urban Planning, that's MEC Lebogang Maile. Also, Cooperative Governance and Traditional Affairs Minister Dr. Nkosazana Dlamini-Zuma were indeed visiting areas affected by the flooding a little bit earlier today. Now, hundreds of people, mostly in informal settlements, have been displaced. Let's cross to our reporter, Ofentse Setimo, now, who is in Mamelodi regarding this story. Ofentse, the flooding seems to continue all around, and all those affected have only one solution, and that is to pick up their lives and try again when this is all over.
Absolutely. Thank you very much, Arabile. As you can see on the picture on screen now, this is the aftermath of what transpired yesterday. You can see the people are even struggling to walk there. As you know, the roads are all muddied up. This area was actually filled up. There was a lot of water here, which has actually subsided over time. We were actually shocked when it came in this morning to find that the water had actually gone down. But earlier on, we were with the Minister of Cooperative Governance and Traditional Affairs, Dr. Nkosazana Dlamini-Zuma, who actually confirmed that there was one fatality in Centurion where a person was apparently electrocuted as they were trying to run away from the floods. And there was the MEC as well for Human Settlement, Lebogang Maile, who also mentioned that they actually want to approach the courts to get a blanket court order that would prevent people to actually settle in uninhabitable areas like this one. As you know, this area has been evacuated a couple of times previously, but the people always come back. The MEC went as far as describing the situation as being anarchy and lawlessness, saying that, you know, as much as the authorities try to locate the people to a place that's suitable for them to reside, they always relocate back to here. So that was the gist of it. You know, the breaking news that actually came out was the fact that there was a fatality. As you remember, from late yesterday, we were reporting that there were no fatalities, as the emergency services actually moved swiftly to come and rescue the people. But there was an outcry from the locals here, saying that, you know, they could have prioritize this area here because this was a more vulnerable area than the one in Centurion. But then later on, we saw the military chopper also coming here to rescue some people. And then there was 150 people that were apparently stuck in a church after the flooding started. You know, as you know, that the water actually rose very quickly. Within an hour, the area was already flooded. So those people were also rescued and they are now in a place of safety. Earlier on, we also mentioned that there was a child who was separated from his mother, and he had described the situation where he left the mother in the water. Fortunately, there's a happy ending to that one, as the two have been reunited. Arabile.
Ofentse, thank you so much for that, but it's just harrowing scenes right behind you. There's South Africans continue to struggle in and amidst that rain-drenched area as well. Thank you so much for that, Ofentse Setimo. They're leaving us with visuals of just how sad it is in and around the Mamelodi area. We'll continue to give you the latest on that. And of course, our news headlines continues, our rolling coverage.